Hey, what's up, guys? This is Mike with We the People Outdoors. My buddy Greg's back there too with us. Today we are at an old site that I found a couple years ago. Just by chance, actually, we got permission from a farmer that he used to own all this land back here, and it was his family farm back in the day. And there was actually another home site that we were going to metal detect, and he said that there was the original log cabin was back in the wood line back here. So we kind of came back here and checked that out, and we ended up getting on some really old stuff, some really old coppers. I got a silver Spanish pistarine, some really other neat relics. So we're back here today to kind of poke around, see what we can find. And we also brought our probes with us to see if we can find some sort of a privy or a little trash pit. So there's a really neat spring house, though, I'm going to show you guys, built into the side of the hill here. It doesn't really look like a good place for a cabin, but we found loads of buttons and other things, so I'm going to take you along with us today, and let's go take a look at the spring house. Alright guys, here you can see the old spring house that kind of made us find the place here. Originally, we were trying to look for it, but I don't believe it's original to the early 1800s. It's definitely older, but you can see some of the mortar work here on it and how it's been either repaired or how it was originally constructed, but it's a neat little old spring house that we got sitting out here in the middle of the woods. See it just built into the side here, this little ravine. So we're gonna try and metal detect a little bit. We pounded the place pretty good, but we're gonna try and detect, see if we can find anything, and then poke around and see if we can find the original privy or maybe some trash dumps. So let's get to it. We think that is possible the old cabin site. It's flat up in here. We found a couple coppers here, the Spanish silver pistarine up here on the fence line, but it's really the only kind of place that we could see them building a log cabin. You can kind of see how close we are. Spring house is down in here, so definitely not the most opportune place to build a cabin, I guess, but they had what they had and they did what they did with it. So Greg's already digging a target, so there must be some stuff here left, so we'll get back to you guys. The old man strikes first. Showing us, I told him we pounded this place, and 5 minutes in, Greg says, I'll show you guys. Alright, nice old flat button.
It was under a bunch of iron.
Oh yeah? You care if I rub the front of it real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
I can't quite tell if there's anything on there, but Greg's got his magic settings on right now. Oh, shank's there. Didn't get it all. Sweet, man.
Flat button, huh?
Yeah. No, I didn't see nothing. Just crusty. Yeah. All right. I'm working.
I can't see.
What's that? Yeah, I think it's just crusty. We'll have to get you those, them readers, the cheaters. So I'm working on a 16-17 over here, but the roots are a pain, so it's going to take a little bit, but we'll get back to you guys. Greg says he's got another button. Probably not even 5 minutes. A little convex one, he says. Flat button. Deep, huh?
Yeah, it was
just kind of sandy there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think anything's on it.
Got some age to it, though. Here, let me get in the light real quick. Cool. Well, there's a good chance we miss some coins then if you're getting two buttons right off the bat. Sweet. I got a little piece of crappy lead, but I think it's old. It's some kind of old lead, but all right, we'll get back to you guys. All right, guys, I got my first find here. Let's see if I can bring it into the light for you. I got a flat button here, 16-17 on the Knox. It almost seems like it has to have some kind of tombeck material to it because it's so shiny.
but it's got on the back, man, I've never found one that shiny that doesn't have the Tomback color to it, but it says the orange color on it on the back. Got the wreath. Might be kind of hard to see, but it's there. Let's see. Yeah, it's not really one to focus, but still a neat find. So, well, that's a good sign. If there's still buttons here, then hopefully we can find something else. Let's keep going. All right. It's been about a half an hour. We're chugging along. Greg just got a sick relic. Got one of those batwing buckles. Man, that's old. Look at that thing.
1830s.
Oh, yeah?
20s.
My goodness. Let's see if I can get that in the frame there. That is old. Dude, that's sweet. Awesome. What was it ringing up?
31.
Oh, boy. I bet you thought you had something. That's good, though.
It was a little, heck yeah, little jumpy because it was so deep, but once I got all the dirt off,
cleaned up a little
solid,
bit.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Right on the hillside here, too, huh? Right in the hill.
This looks like a place they would dump stuff.
Yeah.
To me.
You getting a lot of iron in here,
a lot of
too?
Iron, yeah.
Sweet. Well, hopefully there's some more. If that 30's there, cool find, man.
Thanks.
All right, guys, my next find. Nothing crazy. But an iron spoon bowl. Yeah, it was given I figured it was going to be iron, but it was given a little bit of a chirp on it. Non-ferrous chirp, but take an iron spoon bowl. There's few and far targets left between here, so we'll take what we can get. Let's keep going. Alright, guys, just got another flat button here. It's underneath an old, you can see this old piece of wood here. It was kind of deteriorating right on the edge, so it must have been hiding it before, but nothing on it. Shanks there, though. It's weird. All the ones, I haven't really seen too many with shanks busted off, so. It's been probably about 35, 40 minutes since our last good find, so. We're going to give it a little while longer and maybe start probing and see if we can find where the dumps were, or the privy, or the, possibly an old trash pit, so. We'll go back to you guys. Hey, what's up, guys? This is Mike from We the People Outdoors, and it's the day after where Greg and I got out on that old colonial spot. Found some buttons. He found that really sweet batwing buckle. And today, we're just going to get out a little bit. We're going to do something different, do a little creek walking. I have this creek beside my house where there was actually a lake bed that I actually used to run through it before. Unfortunately, we had the lake bed flood and eroded through the causeway, caused the lake to drain. So, but I've walked through here a few times. We find some neat, some bottles, some shards of pottery. I found an arrowhead, a really nice one, the one you guys will see in the intro of the video. So we're gonna walk around, see what else we can find, see if we can find, you know, anything at all. So I'm gonna take you guys along and we'll see what we find. Here's a good stretch where I found my arrowhead before. You can see, you want to look kind of at these gravel bars here. Whenever we get a big rain, I like to come down and check the gravel bars. It's a little bit harder than searching in fields for arrowheads, but I have found my best arrowhead in one of these gravel bars down here in this creek. So that's what you're going to kind of want to look for. Look for the gravel bars, and I search those. So we'll keep going and we'll see what we find. Well, here's the first find here, just walking up. Picked up this piece of pottery, and looks like part of an old plate, but you can see some of the blue design on the edge, though. Looks like there's some on the back, too, so keep going. I'm sure there's quite a bit of pottery that gets washed down whenever it floods or rains real good, so still a neat little find. Let's keep going. All right, guys, here's the next find. Nothing too crazy. Looks like it's an old piece of a mason jar insert, though. You can see it down here. Let's go ahead and pull it out. Yep, that's what it is. Nothing too crazy. You can dig a lot of these in the dumps. You can see it's got some text on there. Let me wash it off. Now it's hard to read, but I can definitely see where it says mason. Probably says for mason jars. That's cool though too. Just a mason jar insert with the zinc for the zinc cap. So let's keep walking. See, we got a little buddy down here. See the crayfish down in there? Might be hard to see, but see if I can make a move here without attacking me. There are a bunch of little minnows and stuff swimming around. You guys might be able to see them out in there. Pretty neat though. Once we get down around this corner down here, there starts to be a couple more turns in the bank, so stuff seems to get caught up more there, so we should find some more pottery and we'll see what else we can find. Alright, so we got up to another gravel bar. You can see there's broken pieces of stuff laying around. You can see over here, looks like an older, some kind of a jar or something here. Old milk glass jar. Down here, some sort of piece of plate. Nothing too crazy old. See, there's a couple other miscellaneous pieces. Over here, there's a piece of a crock, salt glazed crock. See down here. See that. So, there's always new stuff here that pops up. There's another piece of glass up here. Not too old. Some kind of bottle. So we're gonna check for some arrowheads here, and it's usually a good spot on these gravel bars, so we'll get back to you guys. Alright, we just walked up on this little guy here, swimming around. See if I can get him for you here. Oh, now he's hiding. Let's see where he went. Oh, there he goes. He's burying his head in the sand. Oh, is that him? Nope, here he is. There he is. Cute little guy. What are you doing, bud? Where's all the relics? Where's the arrowheads at? Alright, we'll let you go back in peace. Give me some good luck, though. There he goes. Alright, let's keep moving, guys. Okay, I'm on the other side of the sluice here. This is pretty neat here. You guys can see a bunch of the old, where the turtles would lay their eggs here. See them hatched here. There's a bunch of different beds. See the eggs here, the shells where they came out. There's a bunch of different ones here though. You can see here, down here. There's a couple up in here. So that's pretty neat. Off of the little turtle nests where they look like they all hatch. So see all the eggs though, the egg shells up in here. So that's good to see. All right, we're gonna walk down this way just for a little bit, see what else we can find, wrap it up, see if we come across anything else cool. We'll be back. Well guys, that's gonna wrap it up for me. We walked two different sections of the creek and we didn't really find too much, so just wanted to get out, see if I could add anything else to the video. It's been a little light on content this week. This past weekend we took our oldest boy away for the weekend to celebrate his birthday, so that's when I usually get out and try to film. So hopefully next week's video will have a little bit more in it, and glad you guys stuck around. Thanks for watching. Feel free to subscribe and we'll see you next week.